and solid. It was that cold last night, but the water in my bag is frozen, 4 litres. Bit of ice. For brew. Seriously? Banjo music? Okay. back to Northwest Bushcraft. First of all, I need to say a massive thank you to all the people who have been watching the channel. I had over 1,000 views this weekend. I just topped over 1,000, which is great. You know, I'm not an expert in bushcraft. I'm like everyone else out there. I've watched all the Ray Mears programs, the Bear Grylls programs. It's just, it's something I enjoy doing. I'm not an expert. It's just me coming out, a big bold fella doing his thing. So really, massive thank you. Thanks very much indeed. Now, I've had a couple of requests from the YouTube people asking me to make a few things whilst I'm out, one of which was some food. Now, wild food foraging is one of my major passions. I love wild food foraging, foraging for fungi, edible fungi, that kind of thing. And I've been studying it for years, but today it's a very cold January day. It was -4 last night during the night, so much so that the water in my bottle was frozen this morning. So we've got a fire going now though, so let's have a go at making some bannock bread, because there's very little to forage at the moment. So we'll do some bannock bread in a slightly different style than the most people are used to. Usually it's either cooked in a frying pan or on a hot rock, but this time I'm actually going to use a Tatonka sort of billy can kettle, and we'll make it oven style. Okay, thanks a lot. Okay, so the first thing with the bannock is to make sure you've got the right type of fire. Now, I tend to use this one, which is what I call a range fire. I think it goes by lots of different names. But the idea is you have your main body of the fire at the back, and then here, as it burns down, it produces loads of coals and embers, and that's what you're going to use to cook your bannock in, rather than actual flame itself, because it's just too hot and the bannock will burn almost instantly. Okay, so you need a good bed of embers first. Okay, so here's my way of making bannock bread in the campfire. First, you want a clean pan. This one's the Tatonka kettle, they call it. Why they call it a kettle, I've no idea, but it's the Tatonka kettle. It's the 1.6 litre version. And then here's my dry bannock mix. It's always best to make this up at home and then bring it out with you. The recipe I use is a fairly standard one. It's two parts plain flour. So one part milk powder, maybe 2-3 teaspoons of baking powder, and a pinch of salt. I always keep a bit back in case I add too much water, common mistake of mine. So give it a bit of a flick, get some air back into it. Slowly add the water. Now the thing with bannock is you don't want to overmix it, because what tends to happen is you knock all of the air out of it, because it's the baking powder does all the work for you. Might as well use it all up. More water. go, it's starting to come together now in a dough. You don't want it too wet, otherwise it'll take forever and a day to cook.